So we are out at Penn's Landing. Penn's Landing. They can find some bacon.
Yes. Yes, I enjoyed it.
This was the same people?
I did. I waited in line for 2 pounds of bacon for 20 minutes.
A poppin' shrimp cheese. Let's get that. What is that? Explain it out.
I want fried fries. Y'all still making french fries?
Fried mac and cheese bites. Ooh, that sounds good.
Everybody clap your hands. Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all. How low can you go? Can you go down low? All the way to the floor? How low can you go? Can you bring it to the top? Like it never stop. Can you bring it to the top?
Thank you.
I've been sewing for the past maybe 4 or 5 days. Divas, look at this. Divas and Jets. Wow. It smells like rain in here. I could sit here all day. I turn it around.
Propagated it several times. I have it at my house. It's, yeah. I wanted something that had a little pop of color in it, though. Just, you know, get something different.
The Calathea's.
It's so pretty.
What about this one? Now, this, I see some
that's
color.
That's here too, yeah.
Oh, that's the same type that was in the back?
Yeah, but different variety.
Okay.
But would you, okay. You can use the yellow.
Oh yeah, she definitely lets her water sit. We have water that sits.
but it won't be.
Oh, hey, hey. So I never really mentioned it, but my client, she is, what do they call it? She's basically wheelchair bound. I got a whole bunch of elastics. And the story is behind this elastic. So she's basically wheelchair bound. The thing is, we had an interesting time getting pants on her. And because so, I decided not to do the fastened option. So, I am going to basically go without that option. I had never, when I did her measurements, I never had a chance to have her lay flat. Like, I did the best that I could with her sitting inside of the wheelchair, that I never realized that her legs kind of bends and she has a hard time fully extending her legs. I'm just assuming, because it was really interesting getting her dressed. So I want her to be as comfortable as possible. So I definitely want to just make sure she's good. You know what I mean? I have been sewing every day. Even if I go out or I do something, I come home and I come right back to this. I can't really sleep knowing that I have parts that I need to do. So, if that makes any sense. So this is a 3-inch waistband that does not roll. And she's supposed to have high waist. So it is a high waist and it's also a high waistband. So if she's not comfortable with wearing her stomach out, it won't be much that's out. Vitamins. If I haven't showed y'all this already, I do take them with a meal sometimes, and then sometimes I kind of don't. But I am gonna cook me some dinner tonight. I did take out some salmon. I go to the door and I'm like,
what on earth is the Amazon people dropping off, right? So this man, he had a package in his hand. So I'm thinking, okay, it's just one package. Only for me to finally get to the door, because, you know, they knock now. I guess they knock just to say, hey, I'm letting you know your package is out here before somebody take it. When I say he had all these boxes for all on the step, I said, oh no, what the fuck? And then they all was heavy. But yes, yeah, so I'm like, what the hell? So I know, you know, being at my mother's house is very interesting. And I want to start getting into, hold up. I want to start getting into looking for some places. But I am learning my family the more that I'm around them. Like, even though I miss, you know, just having my own for a little while, I'm like, I'm getting to know that y'all is a piece of fucking work, because she orders stuff every 5 minutes. Every 5 minutes. I'm like, what are you ordering now? So, anyway, I gotta show y'all the accumulation of all these damn boxes near the door. It looks like a fucking warehouse. I'm cracking up. So I'm just gonna put my semen on. I don't know what I'm gonna do for a side, but I do want something good, because I be hungry. But I think sitting at the sewing machine, we had this perception that people that sit at the sewing machine or sit at a desk all day, that it's not actual like hard labor. I don't know what it is. I get really tired within the first few hours of sitting here. I don't know. Yeah, so I don't know if it's the weather or what, but men are popping out of the woodworks. Like, old flings, old relationships, old boyfriends, they're popping out of the fucking woodworks. Let me sit for a minute. And when I say it's burning me out, it's burning me out. So, I'm a really emotional person. So, I don't know. I'm emotional when it comes to love, you know, friends, family, when it comes to people that matters. Like, not just regular, everyday things. So, my ex was literally in town. And, oh my God. I wound up getting a call from him, and then I wound up talking to another old serious relationship, and I get really emotional every time. And then it's like old friends is popping up, old flings, niggas that I ain't seen in years is like just in the atmosphere. So I'm just like, I don't even know what this is about. This only happens when something big is about to happen. Like, I feel like distractions like this only happens when maybe I have something major going on, or maybe there is like someone new coming into play. I'm gonna put a couple of these cherries just to finish them off. But maybe it is something, someone new. It gotta be someone new in the atmosphere or something, or God is trying to tell me something, because I've never had this many people come into my life that I used to socialize with ever. I'm just gonna say ever. I don't even know how to say it. Like, everybody I ever been with is resurfacing. If I see one other person, it's like, this must be a sign from God. So I'm sitting here, and I have been talking to my friends about it lately, because I had a nervous breakdown, because this one person that like popped up or just popped into my world, you know, via text, via phone call. I started crying so bad that I couldn't get myself together. So I don't know. I feel like a lot of people say, oh, you always go, you know, you always entertain people, or you don't shun them away, or they always have access, or something like that. And I'm like, no, that's not necessarily the case. Sometimes I can just be going about my regular day, and I just see these people, and I feel like it's God saying something. I don't know. But honestly, I think God is really saying, I'm going to put someone new into your life. So this is the onions and the tomatoes. I'm going to put someone new into your life, and I need you to figure out whether you want someone new and the unknown, or do you want something old and the unknown? I don't know. Because I will say this, you know, I'm a human being. I am scared to get to know somebody new if it's going to still be dramatic. You know what I mean? If it's not going to be good, then no. I don't think I'm in a rush to get to know someone. But everybody is popping up, and it's crazy. And I'm starting to think, well, I know I have high confidence. I know I'm beautiful. I know what I bring to the table. But what is keeping y'all around? Because, you know, first thing that people think, oh, I got some good loving. That's what some people think. I'm not even going to be on that type of cocky, you know, I'm not going to have that mindset. Even though I know that I have good loving, I would like to think that I have more to bring to the table than that. So I'm like, what is it that keep y'all coming around? Because at this point, it's scaring me, because I feel like y'all all done got together and had a conference call and said, let's come into her life. And don't be thrown off by me looking crazy. I can transform into a baddie, and I'm still a baddie, even looking like this. The realest beauty is when you chilling with no makeup on. So if you didn't know, now you know. So yes, I'm just thinking to myself, like, what is it? Because y'all are popping out of the woodworks, and it's scaring me. So please stop scaring me. But I don't know what it is. But these men, they want their old thing back. You hear me? They not playing no fucking games neither. And I'm going to say this. May the best man win. If God is putting some new love into my life, and he's trying to weigh out the options and see what I want God to pick the best man for me. God, I don't need to pick. I want you to pick the best man for me. Because if I pick, I'm scared I'm going to pick the wrong person. I want you to pick the absolute best man for me. And I want to be happy with it. I do. So, I'm telling you, I can't make this shit up. I cannot. So we're going to make a pescatarian meal for dinner. I'm going to start sewing. By the time I come back to y'all, I probably would just show y'all my food. I really don't have time to do anything extracurricular outside of what I'm doing, because I want it to be good. So this vlog is really going to be super, super late. But I'm just know that I'm doing the best that I can to juggle everything. Even though some things I feel like I get small rewards, I still love the vlog, so a vlog is gonna come out. So we got some stir fry rice, some salmon with some onions, tomatoes, and celery. And we have some herb chicken tender type of vibe, some hot seed oil, and peach cobbler cornbread with a little splash of a secret. But it's good, and it's enough for everybody.
Divas and gents, finally, we are sending my hottie on wheels off on Brown. When I say it's been 2 weeks of nothing but that sewing machine going, late nights, me being exhausted, and honestly, tailoring is very, very hard. But she looked very, very cute, very, very beautiful. All she wanted was pink. She said, give me pink, and that's it. And I'm like, girl, yes. Pink is a girl's best and favorite color, and we always look good in it.
Let me just tell y'all what I'm eating first. already ate my first little soft shell taco. but I did it with this here, the Gardein plant-based ground beef. And of course I did salt and pepper, and I also added some of this delicious sauce. Get into it. It's like this peach jerk sauce. So delicious. The calories are super low, and it's pretty much what it say, a peach sauce with onions, herbs, garlic, apple cider vinegar, onion powder. Really yummy. So I did that, and I did put a little tab in it, a little Tabitha. I think she has this smoky seasoning, and it really set it off. And I'm hyped. So whenever it's something good, I'm hyped. So I toasted this tortilla wrap in the pan. Very crunchy and good. And I lightly toasted it on the other side because I want to be able to fold it. I put some onions in there, cheddar cheese. This is going to be my second one. It's so good. If you want that taco, like chopstick type of vibe, or a cheesesteak, spaghetti, anything, please go pick this up if you are a vegetarian, pescatarian, anything. So this baby, I just fold her up. The sauce is so fresh. It's not a lot of extra preservatives and stuff and artificial stuff. I guess really good. Take a bite. That's good. You can use it for dipping, whatever. And I love this. This not anybody paying me to say this, like it really tastes good. And I've toasted the tortilla olive oil. And I grilled the onions before I added the meat. Well, the protein supplement. You get a little kick, but it's so subtle. It's so good.